Greetings YouTube, Crosstrain here from World of Tanks, and today I bring you a replay from my M103, which is the Tier 9 American Heavy. Playing today with my brothers from Millard's Minion, Calibran, and Fallen Blade on Windstorm. So this turned out to be probably, I think, my best game ever in this tank. I do love this tank. The M103, I think, is one of the greatest Tier 9s. Now, if you've watched videos on my channel, you know that I dubbed, sort of, the SDI as the greatest Tier 9, or I asked the question anyways, is it the best Tier 9? And personally, I love the SDI. It's a great tank. I just got out of it and bought my IS-4 yesterday. But the thing I like about this tank is, A, the rate of fire on this thing is extraordinary for a Tier 9, and it's got not great alpha output damage, but it's got decent alpha output, and it is flexible, though. It has considerably more speed than the STI does, which means that you can flex with this a lot more, which you are going to see in this battle, because I do an awful lot of flexing in this battle. I'm setting up early here in the city on Windstorm, and assuming that I'm going to see some company come along this corner. So I'm just sitting here waiting with Calibran and Fallen Blade at my backside, and sure enough, trees fall in front of me. And STI, speaking of that, I put one in him for 373 hit points. And Calibran also put one in him just behind me. Now, right about this time, I said to my platoon mates, I don't like this position. Artie probably has an angle on me, so I'm going to move. And sure enough, right there, I took an Artie shell right off the front of my tank. So I just had a feeling that I was, considering that oftentimes where I'm sitting right there, oftentimes Artie is sitting over in this general area, which I knew then that he might have an angle on me. So, moved not a moment too soon. It wasn't a real big, I'm guessing that was probably that M12, perhaps, that was shooting at me there. So, while it would have certainly hurt me, it wasn't a monstrous Artie. So I would have been okay. Now I'm just repositioning to see what else I can hit. That WZ-111-14 is behind cover. So I'm just kind of indecisive right here. A couple times in this game I get indecisive. But what I do notice is that our middle looks to be in trouble. So I just asked Fallen Blade if he'd move up. Let me slide past him. I'm going to go take a look in the middle, and I'm talking about right in here. You see they got four tanks. We've got two that are left here. So I just said we're in trouble right here, so I'm going to move and I get a fortuitous shot into the side of that SU-122-44, which is a Tier 7 premium Russian TD. So I got one in him, but I just wanted to go fortify this middle because we are, in fact, shorthanded here. So I am moving over here. Moving here, I see this conqueror out here. We both take a shot at each other. He bounces off me, and I'm not sure. I think I missed him completely. At any rate, we're down one tank right now. I see up in the north as well, we've got this STI and this E-75 doing a little dance here. So that's an area of potential concern. There is concern here. All of our tanks are not gone, except for me kind of watching this middle right here. I am talking to Calibran and Fallen Blade. I am talking to them and telling them that I might need some help here. So you can see on the mini-map that they are slowly moving this way. So our T-54 just drowned himself. Beautiful. You gotta love when your teammates do that. We're down two tanks at this point. And you can see this Conqueror is coming for me. So at this point now, Calibran and Fallen Blade have both come. I see that he's taking a shotgun and pull out and put a shot into him for a 397. And he is going to get whacked in the side by one of my platoon mates as well. He hits me for 441, moves in on me, so he stops taking those flank shots, but I'm just going to get up and face hug him. He's going to bounce that shot right there, and he's not going to be so lucky with mine. I'm going to finish off that Conqueror right there. Again, one of the beauties of this tank is that it is an American heavy that gets pretty favorable. Oh man, lots of stuff going on here. That you can face hug in. So right now I'm trying to. The RHM is up top in the castle, right up to my right. So trying to figure out. This is my second area where I'm really indecisive. Trying to figure out how do I get to him. How do I help my teammates who are in his eyeballs to be protected from him. As you can see, our ISU-152 is going up to cross the bridge just to my left. I decide I'm going to flank around this guy, and then I go, no, never mind. I'm going to go back with that ISU-152 because the RHM just showed up on the ground. He's no longer up top in the castle. So I determine that I am going to head off up the middle to see if I can help with this Roomba. Our ISU-152 is calling for help right now. He's going to get really lucky right now, because he just got shot by the Roomba and did nothing but track him. So really, he's crying a little bit in the chat, but that's okay. I'm going to come up around the corner. I'm not sure if this Roomba was not looking or just not reloaded again. But I hit him, finish him off for my third kill. You can see Celebran just got arty'd in the city, so he is down in his E-75. And I am off to find this T-29 that was last seen in the middle here, as well as there's still a couple more tanks over here. So I'm rolling off to see what I got. I've got mostly full health. I did take the one shot from the Carnivon, I think. But rolling through, see, ooh, hey, look what I see. There's a T-29. He is gonna, actually, this is a nice shot. He whacks me for 294. And guess what else I found? Oh, the tortoise. Oh, look, an Arty as well. So there's a nice little series. The tortoise is back to my backside. Fortunately, what you can't see happening right now behind me is that our ISU-152 did get a tracking shot on him. So he's tracked right there, and I turn around just in time to... I'm just going to try to track him as well. He's trying to get out of here at this point, but... I am going to keep him. Now there's nothing he can do. If he used his repair kit, if he had one, after he was tracked by ISU-152, but I've retracked him now. See, Fallen Blades just went down in the city to their other heavy. So I'm just keeping him perpetually tracked right here. Do it again. And then our ISU-152 is going to get the kill shot on him. So I have 5 kills right now. I've got this WZ-111-14. Just to my south, and honestly, I'm going, oh, please, let me just get this kill, let me get this guy, and he doesn't have a whole lot left. Our E-75 doesn't either, so they're doing a little dance with each other, and I take a really bad shot right here. I have the side of this tank, and I come in here just too quick, try to snap off a shot too quick, and just bounce one. And I decide that I have plenty of hit points to go in on him, so I did take a pretty big shot at 460, but I was able to finish him off. He only had 128 when I took just a little bit of time to take my shot. I was able to get him off. So I've secured the Top Gun at this point. There's nothing left but the M12 to find. I've got 3,809 damage. Nice win 8 on this one of 4,500 plus. Just for the damage that I've done in the game, so the 6 kills will certainly help. I think I ended up with about 7,000 win 8 on this. So I am moving up the side, figuring Arty might be up to my left, or and I'm going to go look for him, hoping to get a 7th kill. And whoa, there he is, and watch this. I had an opportunity to go over 4,000 damage, but I... Oh my gosh, that was just horrific. What kind of a shot was that. I shot so far behind him, it wasn't funny. But I had a chance to go over 4,000 damage and missed it by, a bad shot. But anyways, we won the game, picked up my Top Gun. I'm pretty happy with that. It is, like I said, my best game ever in this tank. So let's just take a look real quickly at the post-game stats. So you can see that I had a first class mastery badge. With a double, I 3,560 XP. You can see I did a whole bunch, damaged a bunch of tanks here. So team score perspective, damage. Well, from a damage standpoint, I was at the top, 3805, so I out-damaged anybody in the game by almost 1,000. This WZ had a nice game over here with 2,900 damage. Got the 6 kills from a raw base XP, 1,187. That's good enough for, as I said, a first-class mastery badge in this 103. If you go over to this page, I hit 15 of 16 shots, 11 of which penetrated. Again, 3,800 plus damage. 800 blocked by armor, so I blocked a couple of shots that hit me. You can see two non-pens worth about 800. A little bit of assist damage, and 2.6 kilometers I traveled. So with premium, I made almost 57,000 credits, grossed after, or netted after expenses, 25,000. So this was a good game for me. Really pretty pleased with it. This is a great tank. As I said, this tank has the speed and to flex a little bit, as you saw me do there, move from the city off to the center to try to hold the center a little bit. And then it's got a great rate of fire, puts out not great alpha damage, but enough every 9.5 or 10 seconds, whatever it is, to get the job done. So it is a great tank. I highly recommend this tank. Like I said, the STI is a great tank, certainly meatier than this in terms of armor and blocking shots with its armor. But it has nowhere near the flexibility this tank has. So I would say that the M103 wins my favorite personally for Tier 9 heavy tanks by just a small margin over the STI. So again, this is Crosstrain from World of Tanks and bringing you just this nice replay from my M103. Until next time, I'll see you on the battlefield. Peace.